Hi, nice to see you again. Today we're going to do this. We are going to apply our effects on the source clip. If you didn't know about this yet, this can be a huge time saver, making your life easier and giving you more time for all the fun and creative stuff. Applying effects to the source clips is going to save you from a lot of unnecessary clicks. Therefore, it's going to save you a lot of time. And you can be sure you will never overlook anything. Also, it's going to make processing some parts of any feedback a client might have a lot easier. When you're editing an interview or a piece to camera video, your source material will likely consist of just a handful of shots. This video you're watching right now, for example, is shot in one take. As you all know, video editing starts with the content. So first you start by spotting the footage, then you lay down the story, you add the B-roll. Well, you know the drill. Color correction and color grading are typically steps that take place near the end of the editing process. So say I've put together a decent item story-wise. It's now time for some color correction. So I'll go to the first clip and with Lumetri Color, I'll adjust the colors until I'm satisfied. To get the same effect to all the other clips, I would have to copy the Lumetri effect, select all the other clips from the scene except for the first one obviously, and paste the effect by pressing Command V when you're on Mac or Control V when you're on Windows. Yes, technically you could do this with an adjustment layer, but it would make for an overcomplicated timeline with the shots of me in the studio on video track 1, the adjustment layer on video track 2, the B-roll shots on video track 3, the adjustment layer with the color correction for the B-roll shots on track 4, then an adjustment layer with the overall look and feel and further color grading. It would become a sequence with way too many video tracks, getting all too confusing and leaving too much room for error. In addition, this method also makes applying some transitions unnecessarily complicated. So, to keep everything tidy and orderly, we'll want to apply the basic color corrections on the clip itself. Now, say the client has feedback. Say they want the whole piece to camera part to be more bluish and have a vignette. Now we have to remove the color correction from all the clips from this scene. Adjust the colors on one clip until it's good, copy the effect, select all the other clips from the scene, and paste the effect. Instead of applying, copying, and pasting the effect on every instance of this clip as it's cut on our sequence, we can also apply the effect to the source clip. Let's select the clip on our sequence and go to the Effect Controls panel. By default, we will see all the effects that are applied to this clip. Up here, we can see the name of the clip. And to the left of that, we see Source and the name of the clip. If we click that, we see an empty panel. We can drag or paste effects over here. Any effect we put here will be applied to the master clip everywhere on our timeline. When you zoom in on your sequence, you can see a little FX icon. When you've applied effects to your source clip, it will have a red line under it, everywhere on your timeline. In this case, the video of me talking to the camera was recorded in one take. So by applying the color correction using the source and the effect controls panel, we've fixed the color for every time the shot makes an appearance in the video. And also for processing feedback. We can easily apply the effects we want to the source clip and it will be fixed for the entire video. We don't have to copy, we don't have to paste, we don't have to double check if we've applied the effects to every shot. It's just wonderful. By the way, if you want to adjust specific parts of the recording, you can still do so, of course, by adding effects to individual clips. And that's all there is to it. Easy as 1, 2, 3.